Good day, everyone. My name is Nika Joy V. Salamera, and my topic for today is all about interjection. The interjection has two subtopics, the definition and rules. Interjections are bound by context, meaning that their interpretation is largely dependent on the time and place at which they are uttered. In linguistics, interjections can also be considered a form of thesis. Although their meaning is fixed, there is also a referring element which is tied to the situation. For example, the use of the interjection "wow" necessarily references some relation between the speaker and something that has just caused surprise to the speaker at the moment of the utterance. Without context, the listener would not know the reference of the expression or the source of the surprise. Similarly, the interjection "ouch" generally expresses pain, but also requires contextual information for the listener to determine the referent of the expression or the cause of the pain. While we can often see deictic or indexial elements in expressive interjections, examples of in reference are perhaps more clearly illustrated in the use of imperative examples. Volitive interjections such as ahem, psst, and shh could be considered imperative, as the speaker is requesting or demanding something from the listener. Similar to the deictic pronoun "you," the referent of this expression changes dependent on the context of the utterance. There are types of interjection. Interjection is divided into the following types on the basis ways to express interjections in the sentence, such as greeting, joy, surprise, approval, sorrow, attention, and calling. Interjections for greeting. This type of interjection is used in the sentence to indicate the emotion of warmth to the person meeting, which as say "hi," "hello," "hey," and etc. For example, "Hey, nice to see you here in the party," or "Hello, I'm Pocha." Interjections for joy. This type of interjection is used in the sentence to indicate immediate joy and happiness on any happy occasion that occurred, such as "hurrah," "wow," "hooray," and etc. For example, "Wow, you are looking gorgeous," or "Hooray, we have successfully won this football match." Interjections for approval. This type of interjection is used in the sentence to express the strong sense of approval or agreement for something that has happened, such as "done," "bravo," "brilliant," and etc. For example, "Well done, you win the race," "Bravo, the first rank is yours this year." Interjection for attention. This type of interjection is used in the sentence to draw the attention of someone, such as "look," "behold," "listen," "hush," and etc. Example, "look, you're so arrogant," or "listen, I have never copied you," or "behold, someone strange is there." Interjection for surprise. This type of interjection is used in the sentence to express the strong sense of surprise about something that has happened, such as "huh," "what," "hey," "ah." For example, "what, you failed?" Or, "oh, really, you completed the task? I can't believe." Interjections for sorrow. This type of interjection is used in the sentence to express the emotion of sadness about something unfortunate that has happened, such as "alas," "ouch," "ah," "oh," or etc. For example, "ouch, it's very paining," or "alas, he is no more." Interjections for understanding or and misunderstanding. Interjections for understanding and misunderstandings are used to express one's understandings of a subject being talked about or something which wasn't well understood before the moment. What is interjection? Interjections are words intended to express different levels of emotion or surprise, and are usually seen as independent grammatically from the main sentence. Interjections usually stand alone and are often punctuated with an exclamation point. An interjection is a word or expression that occurs as an utterance on its own and expresses a spontaneous feeling or recitation. Reaction. It's a diverse category encompassing many different parts of speech, such as exclamations, ouch, wow, curse, damn, greetings, hey, bye, yeah. Responses particles, okay, oh, hmm. Hesitation markers like, and other words is stop or cool. Due to its diverse nature, the category of interjections partly overlaps with few other categories like profanities, discourse marks and fillers. The use and linguistic discussion of interjections can be traced historically through the Greek and Latin modistae over many centuries. Interjections are unique and have some interesting features. Interjections don't have a grammatical function in the sentence construction. They usually cannot be modified or inflected. They do not have to have a relation to the other parts of the sentence, and thus, they are highly context-sensitive. Interjections mainly have four roles. Rule number one. Interjections express a sudden mood, emotions, and feeling with emphasis. There are also many taboo words that are usually used in everyday conversation but in formal aspects. These words fall into the category of interjection. Rule number two. Some interjections interrupt a conversation or a thought or hold someone's attention for a moment. These are just sounds, not words, because these sounds do not make any sense. Rule number three. Some interjections express only yes or no. And rule number four, some interjections are used to get someone's attention. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you for listening and watching. Once again, I'm Nika Joy V. Salamera from BS Ed 1.